अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्कॉलर्स, यू आर लिसनिंग टू जियाउर रहमान। स्कॉलर्स, टुडे इज लेक्चर 50 एंड पार्ट 9 ऑफ द लेक्चर 50। टुडे वी आर डिलीवरिंग आवर नॉलेज, आवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट पाथ एनालिसिस, दैट इज द डायरेक्ट, इनडायरेक्ट एंड टोटल इफेक्ट। एंड वी कैन शो यू द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ द PLS सॉफ्टवेयर वेयर दीज पाथ एनालिसिस आर एग्जिस्टेड and how you can extract these results and these paths for your analysis in thesis and in your paper. Scholars, in previous lecture we deliver about structural equation modeling, SEM, and then we have done the structural equation modeling by using the PLS software. If you have not subscribed to our channel, it is requested to please subscribe it. Please click on bell icon so that you can receive the notification of all windows or new videos. If you like our video, please click on like button. Path analysis is a form of multiple regression statistical analysis that is used to evaluate causal relationship, causal models. What means by causal model? See our previous lectures in which we deliver a lecture about cause and effect relationship and correlation studies, difference between cause and effect and correlation. So path analysis is used in the studies where cause and effect relationship is existed by examining the relationships between a dependent variable and two or more independent variables. Read it again. Path analysis is a form of multiple regression statistical analysis that is used to evaluate causal models by examining the relationship between a dependent variable and two or more independent variables. Scholars, please see at the simple model. This is a leadership, this is independent variable, and it has a direct relationship, direct impact on the firm performance. Leadership, and this is a path. This arrow sign is a path. This path means that independent variable leadership has a direct impact on the dependent variable, which is the firm performance. And then there is the second path. Leadership has a impact on employee behavior. And then there is a third path. Employee behavior is a impact on firm performance. Then there is a direct path that is a moderated effect. Moderated effect, you also named it as a indirect relationship. So how the interaction effect of leadership and policies impact the employee behavior. And then there is another indirect path, which is the impact of leadership on firm performance through the mediating role of employee behavior. Look it as here in the PLS software. So this is the direct path. Indirect path, the p value is significant and beta value is 0.35. So leadership is a having an impact on the employee behavior at beta value 0.35 and p value 100% significant. Leadership is having a positive direct impact on, yet this is a direct impact. This is a direct impact. Beta value 0.20 and p value 100% significant. Employee behavior is a direct impact on, positive impact on firm performance. Beta value 0.25 and p value 0.01. 100% significant, which means there is some indirect impacts also. So the interaction effect of the leadership and policy, the moderated, which means that the moderated effect of the policy on the relationship between leadership and employee behavior, which is also positive and significant at 95% interval, confidence interval, where the beta value is 0.10 and p value is 0.02. So this is acceptable. And there is some other path analysis you can see at here. These are the direct path, leadership, these are the beta values, impact of leadership on direct impact of leadership on firm performance, that is its p value, it is significant. The impact of leadership on employee behavior, this is a direct relationship, direct path. So p value is also significant. direct relationship of employee behavior on firm performance. This is its p value, this is a p value, and this is a beta value. So this relationship is also significant. This is a moderated effect of policy on employee behavior. This is its beta value, and this is the p value. So all these are the direct paths, and there are some indirect path as well. Indirect path means what is the effect of leadership on firm performance through the mediating role of employee behavior. This is the indirect path. And further, what is the role of leadership and employee behavior, leadership on firm performance through the moderated mediation role of policy and employee behavior. Look at this. Click on view indirect and total effect. Click on view indirect and total effect table view. These are the indirect effects. Indirect effect means, I told you earlier that what is the impact of leadership on firm performance through the mediating role of employee behavior, and then what is the role impact of leadership on firm performance through the moderated mediation role of policy and employee behavior. So these are their results. This is the indirect effect. It is stated at here, indirect effect for both with two segments. This is the indirect effect of leadership on firm performance through the mediating role of employee behavior, and its p value is significant. And this is the moderated mediation impact of leadership on firm performance. Leadership on firm performance, but its p value is not significant, so this hypothesis is rejected. First indirect impact is the impact of leadership on firm performance through the mediating role of employee behavior, and the second indirect impact of the leadership on firm performance through the moderated mediation impact of the policy and employee behavior. So one indirect impact is significant at 95% confidence interval, and beta value is 0.089, and the second indirect impact, which is the moderated mediation, is not significant, and this hypothesis is rejected. At the end, you can see that the total impact means it is actually a sum of the direct effect and the indirect effect. This is the total effect p values. This is the total effect. Total effect means the sum of the direct effect and the indirect effect. Sum of the direct effect and the sum and the indirect effect. So here we see that the direct effect, view path coefficient and p values. These are the direct effect, and here we see the in upper part the indirect effect. Indirect effect, and at the end we see the total effect. So total effect is the sum of the direct effect and the indirect effect. Scholar, this is the all about our today's lecture. In the next lecture, if you have not subscribed to our channel, it is requested to please subscribe it. In the next lecture, we will deliver our knowledge about what is the mediation analysis, how to draw the results, and how to interpret these results into thesis and research paper. Then all the three coming lectures are important. What is the moderated analysis, and what means by the moderated mediation analysis, how to draw these results, and how to interpret these results in our thesis and research paper. So it is requested to please listen all these three lectures. If you have not subscribed to our channel, it is requested to please subscribe it. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.